Welcome to Uncle Dave's Brigade. Well, it's summertime and it is hot in Houston. I'm going to tell you that. It's in the upper 90s already in June, and it's going to only get hotter. Wait till August, September here. But today we've got Summer in the City with 11 Spoonful, talking about just that very fact, how hot it is. So I thought it'd be appropriate to play today. Hadn't hit the 11 Spoonful yet, but if you're new here, welcome. And the way I do it is I speak in the beginning, speak at the end. I don't interrupt the video. Let it play all the way through so you get the flow of the song. So, got a black and white video of the 11 Spoonful starring John Sebastian. I'll talk about him and talk about the song and the sound effects, how they got came about that. And another song you might be very familiar with that John did that you may not be associated with his name. So, let's pull up the video. You can hit like, subscribe, post notification bell, make a comment, join the brigade, okay?
Hot town, summer in the city, back of my neck getting dirt and gritty. Bend down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match, yeah. But at night it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on and dance all night. Despite the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer, in the city, in the summer, in the city. Cool town, meeting in the city, dressed so fine and looking so pretty. Cool cat, looking for a kitty, gonna look in every corner of the city. Till I'm wheezing like a bus stop, running up the stairs, gonna meet you on the rooftop. But at night it's a different world, go out and find a girl. Come on, if that's all night, despite the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer, in the city, in the summer, in the city.
Used to having a soundtrack of sound effects playing on top of his performance there, so he lost his way a little bit, but that was fun to watch. I love seeing the bloopers, so to speak. But that was in 65. John Sebastian was the lead singer of the group 11 Spoonful. They had a mixture of sounds, so they were folk, blues, rock, even bluegrass. Sometimes they even had a jug in, you know, the old-fashioned whiskey jug that they used to, you know, blow into and make sound. Sometimes on some of their songs they had that, and they were one of the few groups ever to, you know, be in the top charts with a jug in the band. And this was their only number one hit, even though they had a string of hits. This was their only number one, and it hit in August of it actually came out July 4th of 66, hit the top spot in August and stayed there for 3 weeks. So perfect timing on their part. Boy, I bet it was pretty warm during that period of time, as it is now. But this group, 11 Spoonful, the producers who created the Monkees, they actually had the 11 Spoonful in mind, and they were going to build the show around them. And their scheduling of recording and touring and all that, just it just did not work out, you know, because the 11 Spoonful, John Sebastian, called themselves a good time music type band. You know, they were fun, lighthearted. As you can see there, they were cracking up on the stage during the performance. But they were a lighthearted, good time band. And so they saw that, producers saw that in the band. They said, well, let's create the TV show around them. Excuse me. And so that didn't work out. So they created the Monkees instead. And so they had their own created band, which everybody knows a little bit about, which I have not done, by the way. I need to do the Monkees. And now the sound effects, they wanted to put something into it to kind of give that gritty in the city sound kind of thing. So what they did was they brought in an old radio engineer, sound engineer, back in the day when they had radio dramas. You know, if you heard the click clop of a horse, he would be there and actually make that sound, click clop, click clop of a horse. Or you know, he had this old gentleman had just tons of tapes of various sounds, and so they brought him in, and they meticulously went through all these tapes, and they pulled out the honking of the horn, which was a VW Beetle, and they pulled that out, and then you hear other noises, and then you hear the jackhammer, and they got the jackhammer in there, and they blended all that together and put that on top of the song towards the end there. And that's how they came up with the sound effects. And they did that on the second day of recording. They laid down all the music first, and then they came in and then laid down the sound effects on top of it. But it was inspired, the song was inspired by Mark Sebastian, John's 15-year-old brother. He had a poem, and it was something similar to that effect. And he just used that as an inspiration. He didn't copy the poem or anything, but he used that as inspiration, being hot in the city. And he made that the basis of his song. But John is associated, of course, they had lots of other hits in themselves, then went out on his own solo career later on. But he's known for another very famous song, and that's the theme song for Welcome Back, Kotter. He wrote that and sang it, and became the theme song for the show, the TV show back in the day. If you remember, guys, remember Welcome Back, Kotter. That was John. But anyway, that's a little bit about them and the song in the background. Hope you enjoyed it. Hit like, subscribe, post notification bell, leave a comment, and leave a suggestion. If you have a song you want me to get to, I'll try to get to it. Thanks for dropping by. Appreciate you doing that. Be nice to each other. Be nice to yourself, okay?